Hi guys, Adam here. So this is another episode of do-it-yourself electronics, and today I'll be showing something which is based on the solar cells. I recently came across a small solar cells. This is here, so this should be something like 4 volts, and it is pretty forward to be used with the microcontrollers and LCD screens which are operating on 3.3 volts. So I've modified my thermometer and humidity meter to work with such cell. This one is giving 4 volts, and this is, as you remember, the Nokia LCD from an old Nokia phone. So this project is really simple. It consists only of a microcontroller here, which is ATTINY 85, Nokia LCD screen, and some capacitors just to block the distortions on the voltage, and the DHT11 or DHT22, the Chinese temperature sensor and humidity sensor. And it is all powered from two batteries, two AA batteries, or it can be powered from the solar cells, as you can see. So if you look on the circuit board, this one prototype board, we have only two capacitors connectors towards the LCD, towards the power, and DHT11, and that's all. So the vendor of this solar cell declares that it should support something like 100 of milliamperes, but in real life it is much lower than that. I mean, the voltage is correct, but the amperage is much smaller than this. Okay, as you can see, it is only less than 30 milliamps, so it is much less than declared. But anyway, it is sufficient to work with this small thermometer, as you can see, because it consumes only up to 5 milliamps, I believe. It also uses some power down mode on the microcontroller to conserve the power. But anyway, you can combine this solar cell with some kind of lithium polymer battery, which can be charged when there's a sun, and you can build a simple material temperature and humidity station. So it is as simple as on this schematic. Okay, so what about the voltage of this solar cell? So basically it is available in several types, so you can buy with the voltage you need. This one actually is meant to be 4 volts, but I believe it's something higher than this. Let's check this one. Yeah, it's 4.3, but you can select from 1.5 volts up to 12 volts, I believe. It is available in many types, so as I said, you can fit to your board as you wish. That depends on the voltage you need. So I do recommend to use solar batteries if you're building something that is meant to work outdoors, but remember that you need to attach some additional power when there is no sunlight, so your device could work 24 hours a day. Okay, Okay, thank you very much. That's all for now. Hope you enjoyed the video. Give some likes and subscribe. Bye-bye.